Yo, how's everybody doing? It's the Hawking Regime here, and today I'm coming at you guys with a debut of a new series here on the Hawking Regime channel. It's going to be called Hump Day Hit or Miss every single Wednesday of the year. As long as the NFL is on, I'm going to be doing weekly predictions of NFL teams, obviously of whether or not they will win or lose. And I'm going to try and keep track on a weekly basis of how many games I get right and how many games I get wrong going into the next week. And we'll see how things develop with this series and how things shake up. But starting off with week one in the NFL, the debut of the 2016-2017 season will start in Mile High. Denver going up against the Carolina Panthers Super Bowl rematch. Very interesting game in Denver. And, you know, there's lots of things that have changed with Denver over the past offseason. Obviously, Peyton Manning retires. Malik Jackson goes to Jacksonville. They re-signed Von Miller to a big boy contract, so that was good for them. They lose Danny Trevathan, so they lost some players. Offensively, Brock Osweiler is also gone. He goes to Houston. And Carolina, they're getting Kelvin Benjamin back. They do lose Josh Norman, but still a very strong team. But they are playing in Denver. And this is a tough game to pick, really, because both teams are very good defensively. And I tend to pick teams that have good defensive units. But I think that Carolina will come out with a victory in this game, just because I think that as a quarterback, in the quarterback situation, they're more established with Cam Newton. You know, they probably had a lot of time to prepare as well for this Denver defense, so they can make some adjustments. And not that Denver can't have success. They have excellent talent, both in the receiving and running game. C.J. Anderson, along with Emmanuel Sanders and Demaryius Thomas on the outsides to help them out. But I just still feel like at the end of the day, they need to establish a connection between Trevor Siemian and, you know, the receivers, and they haven't had the opportunity to do that really. And I don't think it's a great way to start off with that connection is against the Carolina Panthers. So I'm going with Carolina, even though it is in Denver. Now Green Bay going up against Jacksonville in Jacksonville. The Green Bay Packers obviously have one of the greatest quarterbacks in the league. In my personal opinion, he is the greatest quarterback in the league. Aaron Rodgers going up against the Jacksonville Jaguars, a team that has really revamped their roster, acquiring Chris Ivory, Malik Jackson, Jalen Ramsey, just to name a few of the guys that they picked up. And then obviously Allen Robinson and Allen Hurns have turned out to be pretty good receivers for them. Blake Bortles has turned out to be a very good quarterback. And, you know, TJ Yeldon in the backfield. So they got plenty of talent all across the board. Mercedes Lewis and Julius Thomas as well. So great team in terms of talent. We'll see how it transfers onto the field. Them and Oakland, in my opinion, are the two young teams that a lot of people really are looking forward to seeing, you know, trying to grow, see how they develop. And I just feel like Green Bay, the fact that they are healthy, even though it is in Jacksonville, I feel like the fact that they are healthy really gives them an edge, because when they're healthy, they're really just tough to stop offensively, and they have a very defensively stingy unit, and they're one of the greatest organizations around the league. So I think they're going to come prepared in Jacksonville to take care of business on Sunday. Now San Diego going to Kansas City to play. I got Kansas City winning this game. I just think defensively it's tough for the Chargers to compete with a Kansas City team that can run the ball very effectively, and vice versa. I think that even though the Chargers have some weapons on the offensive side of the football, Kansas City defensively is among one of the better units in the league. Obviously you have Tom Bahali. Usually they have Justin Houston. I'm not sure if he's playing or not. I thought he was hurt for a while, but I don't know. I haven't kept up with the Kansas City Chiefs defense too much. Eric Berry, Ron Parker, Derek Johnson, just to name a few of their guys on the defensive side of the football. A very competent defensive unit for sure. And the ground attack for them, I feel like, is extremely effective with Sharkandrick West, now Davis, Spencer Ware, if I'm not mistaken, is still there. Jamal Charles, I don't think he's going to play, but, I mean, they got plenty of options, I think, with Travis Kelce and Jeremy Maclin to make things happen for them. So I have Kansas City winning this game at home. Raiders going to the Superdome in New Orleans. This is an interesting one because, obviously, the Saints haven't had a ton of success in the past couple of years, and they haven't done a bunch in the offseason to really improve their defense as a whole, or team as a whole, and there's definitely some, you know, major problems with their team defensively, and you know, argue some other spots as well. But Oakland, you know, a team that's really rising in terms of their talent. They bring in Bruce Irvin from Seattle. They got Malcolm Smith from Seattle actually a year back as well. They're trying to build their team in a very good way, I think. I think a lot of their players are getting, a lot of the team is built and based off of guys that are very young. They bring in some veterans like Reggie Nelson to help solidify the team as a whole. But at the end of the day, the talent of Derek Carr, Amari Cooper, that combination, and they hope that Khalil Mack and Bruce Irvin on the outside can lead the offense and defense, respectively, to victory. And I have New Orleans actually winning this game just because I think that New Orleans playing in the Superdome is very tough to deal with. Obviously, defensively, New Orleans isn't known for being a great team, but I think at the Superdome, they just play tons better, and I think Drew Brees will come prepared with his new weapons, including Kobe Fleener, for New Orleans. And I like New Orleans, so that's why I'm picking them. But I think that at the Superdome, they have a very good chance. Now, Cincinnati going to New York to play the New York Jets. This is an interesting one as well because both these teams are among the top teams in the AFC, in my personal opinion. And I got the Jets winning this one. I think defensively, they're just as good, if not better, than the Cincinnati Bengals defense. And the Bengals lose some experience with Reggie Nelson, along with Leon Hall. They don't have, they still do have Adam Jones. Vontaze Burfict will not be playing, which is another contributor to this game. And they did pick up Carlos Dansby from the Cleveland Browns. At the end of the day, I don't think it will be enough. I think New York will be able to have their way on this Bengals team, both offensively and defensively. Not by a huge margin. I just think that at the end of the day, they'll come out with a victory. Browns going to Philadelphia and playing the Philadelphia Eagles. Now, Cleveland, obviously, they pick up RG3 in the offseason, try and get him as their starter, and Philadelphia will start Carson Wentz. So both teams have players that never played for their team in the regular season before that will be making their debut in Philly this Sunday. And I got Philadelphia winning. I like to pick home field teams in week one, and I'm not going to change it here. Philadelphia, I have them beating the Cleveland Browns. Minnesota Vikings going at Tennessee. Interesting pick as well here because obviously Minnesota, they no longer have their starting quarterback in Teddy Bridgewater. He's out for the year with a torn ACL. The Tennessee Titans, on the other hand, they do have their quarterback, a young Marcus Mariota, trying to grow in this league. And then you add the tandem of Derrick Henry and DeMarco Murray that the Titans hope can become one of the best two or tandems in the league in terms of running back position. Usually I pick the home team thus far, or I've picked a lot of the home teams thus far. I'm actually going to go with Minnesota this game because last year in the playoffs against the Seahawks, Minnesota's got a tough defense, man. I got to be honest. I like their talent all around. Harrison Smith, you know, they add Michael Griffin, Anthony Barr, Eric Hendricks, Everson Griffin, Shreve Floyd. They just got a lot of talent all around defensively, and I think they'll get the job done with that ground attack and Adrian Peterson, a pretty good O-line. They add Laquon Treadwell. I think that whoever they have at quarterback can get the job done just by handing the football off to Adrian Peterson. But we'll see what happens. I got Minnesota winning this one. Chicago Bears at Houston. J.J. Watt will be returning after some time off with his injury. Chicago has actually kind of tried to amp up their roster a little bit. You know, they pick up Josh Sitton recently from the Green Bay Packers to start opposite on the terms of the guard position of Kyle Long. So they got pretty good guard tandem right there. And they also have Danny Trevathan from Denver. And I think there are a couple of defensive players I'm also missing. But Chicago, they tried to build their roster up a little bit stronger. They bring Kevin White back, obviously. Now he's healthy. He's going to be playing in his first ever regular season game, if I'm not mistaken, for the Bears this Sunday against Houston. And Alshon Jeffrey also is there as well. They obviously hope that Jay Cutler can produce. And maybe with some better offensive line, some better protection, based purely off of talent, they can have some more success. But I still got Houston winning this one. Just because I think that they got a lot of options on the receiving core, at the receiving core, with Will Fuller added to the roster along with Braxton Miller. Obviously, they already had DeAndre Hopkins. And running game, I think, will still be strong even without Arian Foster. And they have Lamar Miller now. So I have Houston winning just based off the defensive performance. I think that defensively they can get the job done. Buffalo going into Baltimore. This is an interesting game as well. All of these games seem to be interesting to me, but Baltimore, you know, they had a lot of troubles last year. I actually like Baltimore. In Buffalo, you know, they've had some troubles as well. They've tried to get the team together defensively, one of the better units in the league, but I got Baltimore winning this one. I know it's a tough one. I like to pick the home teams, and I think that Baltimore has a revamped offensive unit, and defensively, although they will struggle, I think, especially stopping the ground attack, I think that they'll get enough stops to win the game. Tampa Bay going at Atlanta, or going to Atlanta to play the Falcons. Interesting one here as well. I got Atlanta winning this one just because I think offensively Atlanta is, you know, very good in terms of their talent. Julio Jones, Devontae Freeman get the job done. Matt Ryan as well, obviously. And they pick up Mohamed Sanu as well from Cincinnati. So I think they have plenty of options to do well against this young Tampa Bay team. Jameis Winston will probably get some good yardage against this Atlanta defense. Not the best in the league, but they do have Dan Quinn, a former Seattle Seahawks defensive coordinator, that I think will do a better job, as he showed last year, defensively for Atlanta than they have had in the past. Now we're going into the NFC East with New York Giants going against the an NFC East matchup. The Giants playing in Dallas. Now, if Dallas actually had Tony Romo, I would probably pick Dallas for this game. But I don't know, man. This is a tough one. New York in Dallas. Dallas obviously is going to start with or going to roll with Dak Prescott. Man, this is a tough one. I think that this is kind of a toss-up right here, man. I'm going to go with the New York Giants, man. I just think that defensively they've revamped their defense to a pretty good level. I think Dak Prescott, you know, at home is going to be more comfortable for sure. But again, it's the NFL. It's not easy to transition playing against these teams. I don't think the Giants have the greatest defense in the league by any stretch of the imagination. But I think that, you know, I think New York's actually going to bring the pass rush a little bit, even with that great offensive line that Dallas has. Now, Detroit playing in Indianapolis. Both these teams, I don't expect them to be unbelievable this year. I'm not even sure that either of these teams will actually end up making the playoffs, although the Colts have a legitimate shot. I got the Colts winning this game. Andrew Luck is a very solid quarterback. He's coming off of an injury, so he's trying to bring it back for Indianapolis. Again, they are at home. I like to pick the home teams. I'm going to go with Indianapolis here with T.Y. Hilton and Andrew Luck. The New England Patriots going up against the Arizona Cardinals in Arizona for Sunday Night Football. Obviously, the New England Patriots do not have Tom Brady for this game, so that will impact them for sure. And, you know, offensively, New England Patriots obviously have some good weapons with Gronkowski, Julian Edelman. I don't know how healthy he will be along with Gronkowski, but Amendola, they got some good options, the receiving core, underrated players. And obviously every year in and year out, they're very good, but they don't have one guy named Tom Brady that helps them a lot. I got the Cardinals winning this one just because I think if they don't win this game, then that means that this is going to be a long year for Arizona. I mean, this is a perfect opportunity to strike. And if you can't start off the year winning against a New England Patriots team without Tom Brady and not at their full strength, and you expect to compete for the Super Bowl, and you're at home, I don't see it happening. I don't see Arizona not taking advantage of this opportunity, because if they don't take advantage of this opportunity, I mean, that's just unbelievable. The Cardinals must not be as good as I think, or the Patriots are just way better than I think. Monday Night Football right here, we got two games as usual every year. Monday Night Football, they play two games the first week. Steelers in Washington and St. Louis in San Francisco. I got the Steelers beating the Redskins just because I think the Steelers offensively are very talented. Defensively, they're trying to get some things together, but at the end of the day, Antonio Brown plus Ben Roethlisberger equals touchdowns for Pittsburgh. And Washington, they got some good players for sure. It is in Washington, but I got Pittsburgh winning this game. St. Louis going into San Francisco. I got St. Louis winning this game. I don't think San Francisco has enough firepower offensively to do anything against the Rams defense. I think the Rams have one of the better and more underrated defenses in the league, with their defensive line presence is just ridiculous. Robert Quinn, William Hayes, Aaron Donald. I mean, it's crazy. Their linebackers are good as well. James Laurinaitis, Alec Ogletree. You know, they got great players. TJ McDonald. So they got a lot of talent around their defensive side of the football. They're going to get the job done in San Francisco. So that will be the conclusion of the long video. Sorry for that. But that will be the conclusion of the video. Once again, hopefully you guys enjoyed. You know, make sure to subscribe to the channel for more of these more of these hump day predictions that I'm going to be doing every Wednesday prior to, obviously, Thursday Night Football, which is, you know, going to come into a reality or set into reality a couple weeks from now, I'm pretty sure. But once again, that will be the conclusion of the video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. And, yep, thanks for watching.